Hello and a warm welcome to the Tamil Nadu Brief. I'm Sam Daniel. The headlines first. A three-year-old boy who went missing found dead, allegedly murdered by a neighbour woman. Police say the body was found in a washing machine. India launches its test run for electric trucks. A 5,500-kilometre long electric vehicle highways to be developed in 6 years. And it's a palm revolution in Tamil Nadu. 1 crore palm trees to be raised in 1 year. It's a disturbing news from the Thirunelveli district of Tamil Nadu. A three-year-old boy who went missing earlier today was found dead, allegedly murdered by a woman neighbour. Police say the boy's mortal remains was found inside a washing machine. Both families, investigators say, have had family or property disputes in the past, and this boy was found playing outside their home last in the morning. The lady has been arrested. She had also lost her son or child earlier and has been in a depression ever since. Investigation is underway and police await the post-mortem report to identify the exact way in which the boy was killed. Today is World Electric Vehicles Day and India launched its test run for electric trucks from Tamil Nadu, seen as the capital for trucks in the country. This would help the government get data, credible data, on the cost benefits of electric trucks. India also has an ambitious plan to convert 5,500 kilometers of highways into electric vehicle highways. This means these stretches or highways would have large charging centers every 50 kilometers. And if any electric vehicle crashes or shuts down for technical reasons, there would be help for battery backup in less than 30 minutes. That's the ambitious plan India has. I got onto the electric truck that was on a test ride from Chennai to Tiruchi and spoke to the program director for the electric vehicle highways across the country. Joining us now, Mr. Abhijit Sinha, the National Program Director for Highways for Electric Vehicles. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
What exactly is this kind of a test ride demonstrating?
I think electric trucks, buses, cars, they have been existing in the ecosystem for a long period now. Also the chargers, both of them, they create a good, realistically very, you know, economical way of moving, but they did not took and they did not got the adoption that we expected. Mm-hmm. So technical trial, regulatory trial companies does within their premises. This is a commercial trial. This will give a speed to commercial adoption and answer all questions that commercial adoption, commercial decision require.
So if it's an e-highway, what does it mean for an electric car or electric truck?
For audience of NDTV, this is very interesting question. E-highway means if you shut down with your electric vehicle on a highway, within 30 minutes you get a backup with a battery, with a connector by the nearest charging station which is having two roadside assistant vehicle. Second, if you are on the e-highway, we will also get charging station after each 50 kilometer, a big one, not a small 1-2 dhaba charger. And this big charging station is having all type of chargers for vehicle, for buses, for trucks, for freight, for two-wheeler, three-wheeler. And these e-highways are also equipped with a certain amount of services, a certain amount of confirmation that you can take this without worrying on.
How important is for the traditional diesel trucks to switch to electric?
For diesel truck, it is much, much more important because diesel trucks currently in use are, you know, under tremendous pressure of a lot of international and national compliances. They have to reduce their carbon footprint. Companies who are using diesel truck, they also have to reduce that carbon footprint. If they will not reduce, then going ahead, there are a lot of export issues going to come up, lot of production, sustainability issue, even indexing of these companies into the stock exchange might get affected coming. So carbon credit is something which they can opt for, but better to at least decarbonize two of your things. One is the power that you take in your plant, and second is the mobility that you use.
What will be the cost in terms of comparison, diesel trucks versus electric, and will it also increase the cost for consumers?
So national emission of logistic expenditure is from 14% to 9%. Is to come in between. Our Minister of Road Transport and Highway has been working relentlessly on this to reduce logistic cost to one digit. Now, how much we will be able to deliver? That's the answer which Tamil Nadu is going to give to people.
Target across India in terms of getting these EV highways ready, and how many vehicles you have in mind? The first two or three?
In India, this is third trial. And Germany has an ambition of 4,000 kilometer e-highway by 2030. India has an ambition of 5,500 kilometer e-highway by 2030.
Thank you so much, Mr. Abhijit Sinha, for your time. That was Mr. Abhijit Sinha, the National Program Director for the EV highways, talking to us as we are on a test tech trial run of an electric truck between Chennai and Trichy going on. And finally, it's a palm revolution in Tamil Nadu with an initiative to plant 1 crore palm seeds in the next 1 year. The initiative began from Dharmaburi district of Tamil Nadu with a massive plan to raise palm trees on the banks of River Kaveri. And the larger idea is to develop this across the state to raise palm trees around all water bodies. In fact, being a great source of food and shelter for ages, the palm is known for its toddy, its neera, and also for its palm fruit and the palm craft products, which many say could be a great alternative for plastics.
Plastic வந்து நமக்கு ஒரு பெரிய சுற்றுச்சூழல் எதிரா இருக்கு. அதுக்காக வந்து இந்த பனை பொருட்கள் பயன்படுத்தினா இந்த பிளாஸ்டிக் பொருட்களை முற்றிலும் ஒழிச்சிடலாம் அப்படிங்கிறது ஒரு கருத்து இருக்கு. அதனால அதிக அளவில் இந்த பனை விதைகளை நடுறோம்.
The palm is also the state tree for Tamil Nadu, and over the years, due to massive deforestation, the state's palm tree count has drastically come down from a whopping 6 crore trees to just around 2 crore trees now.
It is increasing the groundwater. The thousands and thousands of the roots, uncountable roots, the palm tree have.
And now it has become a movement with local communities, students and even the state government joining this great effort to raise 1 crore palm trees across Tamil Nadu.
You can plant your palm seed and you can take a photo through all with the help of Udavi application, and it will be get geo mapped, so lantern long will capture from through the Udavi application, and will be maintaining all the 1 crore palm seed, the growth, the stage and everything, with along with the Tamil Nadu government and Green Era Environmental Organization, Tamil Nadu volunteers and Green Tamil Nadu Mission and SIPCOT together, we are making this possible.
Well, that's all the time we have for in this segment. Hope you liked it. Join us tomorrow, same time. Goodbye.